Thank you. center in the world. To your right, dazzling bright red orange birds, the silver hyacinths. Like the flamingos, the bright colors come from the carotene found in the diet they eat. The short birds are located next to the scarlet ibises. Native to Papua New Guinea, an evening giant. To your left, the world's largest collection of hornbills and toucans. It's made up of 25 white animals, housing 18 species. To your right, windows on paradise. The bird of paradise, all birds on earth. And the Jurong bird park is the first in the world to breed these stunning birds. The bird of paradise. Ladies and gentlemen, we are about to make our
pelicans catch the fish just like what they do in the water. Ready, Nalim? Okay, ready, go! Whoa, okay, watch this. I mentioned to you they have long bills, but look at how they try to catch the fish. Look at that. Look at, whoa. Now, look at the pouch. The pouch of, whoa, like, look at that. Now, the pouch of the pelican serves just like a net. Okay, it can stretch and hold up to 13 liters of water, 13 liters of water. If you're not quite sure how much is 13 liters, your Coke can drink or your soft drink can. You pour that 40 times. That's how much is 13 liters, okay? But of course, they're not that thirsty. They will just sift away the water and then they will just swallow in the fish. Now, the other functions of the pouch of the pelican. Now, have you ever wondered why the pelicans pulsating their pouch? Like this Dalmatian pelican, you can see them vibrating their pouch, right? Now, all birds, they do not have any sweat glands. But for the pelicans, when they pulsate or they vibrate their pouch, it enables them to cool them down. Yeah, just like us using the fan. If you handstand a picture of a pelican right over here, and with this, you'll be able to help us to feed the pelicans for free. We will move down to the jetty afterwards. Now, for those of you who have the hand stamp, we will give you a packet of fish, glove for you to wear, help us to feed the pelicans, and once you're done, we got fresh water for you to wash your hands, and also hand sanitizer, so you don't smell of fish. Okay? Alright? Okay.
Thank you. menghadapi dulu. Thank you. Some treats inside the knots for the birds to find. Okay, for this act, the birds will be flying quite low. People in the flight path, sit down. Yeah, hands down. And a volunteer smile. There you go, very good. Looks like the volunteer is ready. Everyone, look at that nest box on stage. Yes, now when the birds are flying, remember, please put your hands down, okay, for the bird's safety and for the safety of yourself as well. The four birds we have just landed, those are in the parrot family and they are called sun conures. They can be found in South America, usually in huge flocks. Just imagine them in large numbers and how colorful but noisy that would be. But that nest box in which they are flying back to, okay, that nest box was not built by the trainers. It was built by students from Green Ridge Primary School in conjunction with Earth Day. So in this way, we actually get the younger generation to get involved in conservation as well. Oh yes, your friends went that way. A beautiful certain years, everyone. Morning, the male and the female toucan would leave their nest to look for food to feed their young. And that's exactly what we're going to have for you this show. Okay, we're going to have Mr. and Mrs. Horn, our toco toucans, joining us very shortly. But they'll be flying low above more of your heads. People in the center. Would you like that? Yeah, I need your cooperation, okay? When you're taking pictures or videos, sit down. 请坐下. 앉으세요. 不可能的. And put your hands down by your sides. Do not reach out and touch the birds. Can I have your understanding? Yes. Okay, looks like the first volunteer is in position. Mr. and Mrs. Horn will be appearing from that part. Oh! Oh, very nice. Wow, you have lots of supporters there. Very good. Slowly. Now, toco toucans like them, they are the largest in the toucan family, easily recognizable by their bright orange bill. Now, despite having a large beak, toucans remain agile in flight. Okay, they're very good at catching. To demonstrate that, Azza, okay, so he'll be tossing a fruit each for the birds. Let's see if the toucans will be able to catch it for us this afternoon. One, two, three. Up it goes! Oh! Good catch! How about Mrs. Horn? It's your turn. One, two, three, and up it goes again! Oh, that's a really high throw! They do this in the wild as well. Of course, in the wild, there won't be people throwing fruits for them. There'll be insects. Can you imagine insects? Okay, they'll be catching them in mid-flight without stopping. That's how fast these two birds can be. Well, it's time for Mr. and Mrs. Horn to make their way back home. Let's see who will lead the way this afternoon. Home is that way. Bye-bye. Our toco toucans, ladies and gentlemen. Now, what differentiates parrots from other animals is their ability to copy sounds. In the wild, they do that as a form of social communication. Now, Lynn has kindly brought me a yellow-naped Amazon parrot. And these birds are very good at mimicking human speech. Yes, you want to say hello?
Hello!
Very excited. How about introducing yourself? Tell them your name.
Amigo!
His name is Amigo. Amigo, how else can you greet all these nice people?
How are you?
How are you? That was a very polite greeting. I'm fine, Amigo. Now, right now, he's going to impress all of us by counting from 1 to 10. Listen up, okay? First, he will do it in English.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7,
Second song will be a catchy tune and it originates from Indonesia. Rasa Sayang, feelings of love, if I were to translate it. Amigo, can we listen to Rasa Sayang?
Rasa Sayang, eh, Rasa Sayang, eh, eh, ni hatu na na u.
Alright, everyone listen up, okay? I'm gonna start off with a little handshake. Hi, nice to meet you. One more time. Oh, such a friendly parrot. Well, he's going to introduce himself. Tell them your name.
What's your name? What's your name?
Bao.
Did you hear that? His name is Bao Bao. Bao Bao is a Chinese name. It means baby or precious.
What's your name? Bao Bao.
Yeah, very nice. Okay, Bao Bao is going to mimic some sounds, but before that, he wants everyone to keep quiet. That was him, not me. Okay, everyone keep quiet. Alright, sound number one. Somebody's knocking on the door. Okay, I'm not very good. Ah, okay, how do you find out who's knocking? He asked who? Who is it? Well, it might be your neighbor, the puppy dog. Can you mimic the dog? The dog. The dog. Some encouragement for Bao Bao, ladies and gentlemen. Must be a small puppy, a chihuahua. Alright, now Bao Bao here is also into electronic sounds. Let's see if he remembers this one. Let's try that one more time. Okay, somebody's calling him on the telephone, and somebody calls, you have to pick it up and you say hello.
Hello.
Say hello.
Hello.
Oh, that was loud and clear. Well done. But Bao Bao here can also mimic human sounds, sounds that you and I make. Okay, when we are feeling sad, we will cry, right? Okay, Bao Bao, show us how you cry. So sad. Okay, don't be sad. I'm going to try to cheer him up. I'm going to tickle him. He's afraid of tickles. Okay, let's do your happy dance. Wow, so fast this afternoon. Very good. Okay, stop, stop. Alright, now Bao Bao here can also sing a line of the birthday song. By any chance, is there anyone else here celebrating a birthday today? 29th of... Oh, it's your birthday! Happy birthday! Very good. Okay, anybody else? Anybody else? Right here? Okay. No, no. Okay, sorry. Mommy says no. How about here? No? Okay, so just for you then. Did I miss out anyone, Chandra? Just her, yeah? Okay, just for you. Listen up. Bao Bao, a line of the birthday song. Ready? That was so fast. Happy birthday. Okay, I'm going to sing it together with him slowly. Bao Bao?
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday to you.
One last time.
Happy birthday to you.
Let's give him a big hand, ladies and gentlemen, and happy birthday to you. All right, Mama, before you go, you have something sweet to say to everyone. Ready?
I love you.
I love you. One more time.
I love you.
I love you too. Can you wave and say bye-bye to everyone?
Bye-bye.
You have to wave.
Bye-bye.
One more time.
Bye-bye.
A big hand for Bao Bao, our yellow-necked Amazon parrot. But after watching Bao Bao perform, you might be tempted to get a parrot like him as a pet. Well, do think twice, because parrots like them, they need lots of time and commitment. Certain species can even outlive us. So do bear that in mind, okay? Well, the next two birds joining us on stage, they're going to show us how loving hornbills can be. Vicky, our great pipe hornbill, will be flying out from that direction. Whoa, here she comes. Good afternoon, Vicky. Now, great pipe hornbills, they're one of the largest flying hornbills that you can find in this region. Now, in the wild, when the female hornbills wants to nest, they would first look for cavities in trees. Everyone, can you see that nest box? Yeah? Well, that nest box is similar to what we would give our hornbills to nest right here in the Jurong Bird Park. Okay? Everyone at the owl area remains seated, hands down. Hands down. Can you hear her? Oh, that's the vocalization of a great high hornbill. Would you like to check out your nest box? She's very keen. Your nest box is to the right. I like the way she hops. Very cute. Now, if she likes the nest box, she'll hop right in, okay? Vicky, what do you think? I think that as a yes, I like my nest box. What happens in the wild is that the female would then seal herself inside a nest, leaving only a small gap. She would use materials like soil, regurgitated food and even her own droppings. Well, Vicky, if you like the nest, you can seal it up now. That was fast. Vicky, hello? Oh, there she is. Everyone, it's time to turn around. Let's welcome Alfred, the male great pied hornbill. But just imagine in the wild, the female will stay inside the nest for 3, sometimes up to 4 months. And during this time, the male hornbill, he has to find food to feed the entire family. What a hardworking daddy, man. But in the Jurong Bird Park, we have successfully bred oriental pied hornbills using nest boxes just like these. Can everyone still hear me?
Very good.
Okay, and using contributions from the Conservation Fund, we have released some of them into nature reserves and even right here in the Jurong Bird Park. So when you're walking around the park, keep your eyes open for free-flying oriental pied hornbills. Oh, Alfred! Is this still there, Azar? Okay, let's do that one more time. Take 2, all the way back home to Azar. Our hornbill, ladies and gentlemen! Nice music, right? Well, now comes the time to simply enjoy the bird's flight. If you want to volunteer, try and get the trainer's attention. Remain in your seats, okay? But we have Chandra, Saad, and Shariel right over there. Oh, here comes the birds. Okay, we have Vega, our skylight local. We have all joined us. Now, the birds will be flying very close to you later on. Watch them as they fly past you. This is how they will swoop through the branches and trees in the rainforest of South America. We can all help them by using less of everything. Even better, if we can reuse our things, buy secondhand or recycled products. Now this will reduce the need for making new things and clearing of these birds' habitats. Okay, if you're not a volunteer for this act, please remain seated. Yes, sit down please. Photographers included. Photographers included. All right, Patina is going to fly first and off she goes. Vega and Patina, everyone. Very nice flying. A scarlet macaws like them, they have nice, long, beautiful tails. Can you see? Well, they also have powerful wing flaps and excellent eyesight. This allows them to be agile and maneuverable in flight. To demonstrate that, we will be flying the birds again, but this time from different ends of the stage. Okay, let's watch them cross each other's flight path somewhere about in the middle hoop. Okay, I need all who have just arrived to remain seated. Quickly find yourself a seat. Sit down, please. Sit down. Young lady in blue, thank you. Are you ready, Lynn? Ready, go! Thank you very much, Lynn, with Patina. Thank you. All right, now Vega has one more flight to go before he can make his way back home, okay? Saad, did you hear me? I need the hoop. One last flight. You're holding a bag. There's something inside the bag. Okay, everyone look at Saad. There's something inside the bag. Surprise. That's a really small hoop, Saad. Are you sure Vega can fly through that hoop? Oh, he's very confident. Well, I do know that scarlet macaws like Vega, they have streamlined bodies. Look. And this is how they will escape from potential dangers and predators in the wild. But the size of their center hoop is very much smaller compared to the 2 side hoops. It's going to be quite challenging for Vega. Silence please, everyone. Shh. Focus, boy. All yours. Did it just now. Oh, Lynn is calling for you. Okay, one last reward. Ready now, boy? Yeah, getting his well-deserved reward there. Sorry about that, and off she goes. Thank you, Lynn. Monet's gonna have a parrot help me deliver a coupon and a voucher to one lucky volunteer. I need someone up there who's not afraid of birds. Not afraid of birds. Where? Okay, the lady by the aisle area. Yes, would you like to do it? Would you like to stand up on your seat, ma'am? Up on your bench. Yes, okay. You need to put your camera down. Give it to somebody else. Free your hand. Very good. Okay, can you raise your hand to the side like so? Keep still. Palm facing skywards. Yes, the bird will fly up this way. She will land. Do not drop your hand when she puts it down. Hold on tighter. Okay? Smile. We're gonna get Sassy. Sassy is our self-aggressive cockatoo. She'll be helping me deliver this. Are we all set for this? Okay, keep still, okay? Sassy, lady over here. Can you see? Go. Put it down. Close your fingers. Yes, very good. Oh, she's posing for a picture. Look at that. Okay, what a show off. Thank you very much, Sassy. And that lady. Would you like to check what you've got from Sassy? Do you have a small white coupon? Okay, that entitles you to a free drink. Okay, so remember to collect it over there after the show. And the voucher. Some of you may have received the voucher earlier on. That's right. Now remember to redeem it today by 5 p.m. Go to the Clone World. You get a free personalized gift. Okay, so do it today. The Clone World is located at the Birds of Clay playground right that way. All right, thank you very much. One more volunteer, one more. Oh, so many hands now. Listen. This time I'm looking for somebody with a $2 Singapore note. $2 Singapore note, yes. No point standing up. Don't wave your maps at me. People in the flight path, hands down and sit down. Off she goes. Put it down, Sassy. Close your fingers. Okay, a final pose for the picture. She knows she's the star of the show. Thank you very much, Sassy. And our volunteer as well. Thank you for helping me out. Sassy, mission accomplished. You have done a wonderful job. Azza is waiting for you. Off she goes. Thank you, Sassy. In a few moments' time, we will be having our grand finale. So don't go anywhere, all right? Well, I'm sure this afternoon the birds have amazed you, and some of them may have even made you laugh. But please do not forget the bird conservation champions you have met today. Now, we can all help them by making sure that the paper or wood that you buy comes from recycled sources. Now, remember, you and I, we do have the power to choose what we buy. So together, let's make a right choice and make a difference. Oh, looks like we are ready. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, for our grand finale, we're gonna bring out about 80 birds on stage. That's 80 birds, okay? So let's get ready. First pair of pelicans from Africa, the great white pelicans. Next pair of pelicans from India, the spot-billed pelicans. They are all the way from Europe, up down Asia pelicans, here they come! Right now we have 8 birds on stage, but that's not all. We'll be joined by our long-legged beauties, our beautiful flamingos. Here they are. Back home, there will be a photography session with our other group of flamingos. So if you're interested, do stay on for that. In the meantime, you can come down and take pictures of these birds, but please do not touch them, okay? Now before you leave, remember to check out the stuffed toys over there. Okay, those beautiful plush toys are retailing at a special price that you cannot find elsewhere, only right here at the Pools Amphitheatre. Now on behalf of our sponsor, the Singapore Press Holdings Foundation, Do continue to have a great day in the park. Before you leave, take your belongings with you. Thank you and goodbye! Alright, now before we can start our photography session, we will be ushering these birds back home, like I've told you. Let's start by ushering our squadron of pelicans.
Thank you.